Welcome back mga ka-learners! In another lesson, we looked at how we can treat technology as our best friend. Today, we have another of the three lessons in our module entitled Technology for a Better Life. We will go past the home appliances and look at what might be the biggest technological advancement we have to date. Communication technology. You may not become a communications technology expert after this lesson, but you will know enough to understand how big of an impact it has had. We will also look at the most common devices associated with communication technology: a wired telephone, a mobile phone, and a personal computer. The last two connected by the internet. Before we had the telephone, communication usually took one of these two common forms: sending a letter or going to where the other person is and speaking to them directly. There are other forms of communication prior to the boom of the internet and communications technology, but only a few people practice them anymore because they aren't practical today. Technology has helped us progress in the world of communications. But what exactly is communications technology? Communications technology, also known as information technology, refers to all equipment and programs that are used to process and communicate information. It allows us to talk to someone who is not in the exact same place as we are. The person could either be on the other side of your house or the other side of the world. Yet, you would still be able to talk to them thanks to communications technology. It is the backbone of today's society and one of the reasons why we can give you this module in this manner in the first place. This is made possible because of telecommunications equipment, tools or gadgets you can use to communicate. It started with sending letters, talking to people in person, as well as visual signaling through flags, smokes, flares, lamps, and many others. Today, telecommunication equipment usually involves one of the following: 1. A telephone. 2. A mobile or cellular phone. 3. A personal computer or laptop. There are also other forms of telecommunication equipment, like two-way radios and fax machines, but these three have taken the lead as most people's preferred means of communicating. Let's get to know these three and how they are best used to communicate. Let's start with the oldest yet still existing among the three, the telephone. How does it work? When you talk into a telephone or landline, the microphone in the mouthpiece converts your voice into electric pulses. These pulses run through the wires of your phone through a socket on the wall. They then go through cables outside your house and through a switch center that receives and relays your call. The center then directs the signals to the telephone of the person you wish to talk to. Once that signal reaches the receiver of the person you want to talk to, a device in the earpiece converts the signals back to your voice. Now let's look at the most common device you see nowadays: a mobile phone or cellular phone. Mobile phones, known as cellular phones or lately smartphones, are like TV sets and radios. They use radio waves in transmitting messages, either as an SMS or short message service, otherwise known as a text message or as a voice call. Radio waves are invisible energy waves that are widely used in communication. Mobile phones are connected via these invisible waves in a network that makes use of cables, antennas, and satellites. Cell sites help out with the transmission of these radio waves. They are strategically placed so that mobile phone users can reach far places. Lastly, let's look at how to communicate through the internet, via computer, or laptop. The internet provides us not just information on whatever you might want to know, but also a way of communicating with our loved ones without the need to place a phone call or send a text message. The internet is an international network connecting smaller networks in most countries around the world. These networks or groups of computer users are formed by educational, commercial, nonprofit, government, and military organizations. These days, you don't need much to access the internet. All you usually need is a modem and an internet service provider, usually a telecommunications company. You are probably used to using the internet for chatting with your friends, going on social media, or browsing articles or videos on the web. There is, however, another way the internet is used outside of talking to other people. The ATM, or automated teller machine. It lets you withdraw money from your bank account without having to line up at the bank itself. Congratulations on completing this lesson and this module. By now, you should be able to 1. Identify the different kinds of modern appliances being used in your homes. 2. Demonstrate the proper use of these technological advances. 3. Describe the latest in entertainment technology. 4. Demonstrate the proper way of taking care of the appliances and equipment described. 5. Cite the advantages of using these technological advances. 6. Identify different means of communication. 7. Explain how technology can help us communicate with others. 8. Demonstrate the proper use of new communication technology. And 9. Cite the advantages of using computers and other smart machines. Now that you are more familiar with technology, we hope you can use it to help you live an easier life. Hanggang sa muli mga ka-learners,